From KHON2 News, this is Hawaii's Morning News with Kirk Matthews and Kathy Moneno, Hawaii's number one morning news.
Good morning and welcome back to Hawaii's Morning News.
Thanks so much for waking up with us on this Halloween Wednesday, the 31st of October.
Topping our news.
Halloween. It is COPD Awareness Month come November, which is tomorrow, and COPD being chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. With us this morning from the COPD Coalition and who suffers from the disease, Valerie Chang, plus critical care specialist and pulmonologist from Queen's Medical Center and Polymomi, Dr. Thomas Pollard. Good morning. Thanks
good morning.
For being with us. First, Valerie, you were telling me how many people in Hawaii suffer from COPD?
Well, the American Lung Association of Hawaii website says 59,000.
In Hawaii.
And the National Heart, Lung, Blood Institute estimates 12 million in the United States are diagnosed, and another 12 million have it but aren't diagnosed yet.
Doctor, can you explain to us what it is?
COPD is a disease that's predominantly a smoker's, but you don't have to be a smoker to get COPD. There's other disease processes that can give you COPD. But what it is an obstructive lung disease where you can't get all your air out, so you get an obstruction of the air in your lungs. And generally it's a progressive and unrelenting disease. Even when you stop smoking, it generally will progress somewhat.
And no cure, obviously.
There's no cure. There's treatment, but there's no cure.
Okay, and Valerie, living with it, what do you experience?
Well, I've been very fortunate because I'm actually in excellent health other than having severe emphysema. So I can actually do most things, but I have to be very careful not to get any infections, because if I do, the consequences are much more severe than a normal healthy person, because I could end up permanently losing a lot of lung function and end up in the hospital. That's what happens to a lot of people with COPD.
What other symptoms are there?
A lot of people with COPD don't have much symptoms, mainly because the disease is slowly progressive over time and they just limit their activity. So, you know, a lot of people come up and say, well, I'm not able to play golf as good as I used to because I just get tired. I can't climb stairs as well as I used to. And sometimes patients don't present to the physicians until the disease process is late or they get admitted to the hospital with an exacerbation. So one of the things we're trying to advocate is pulmonary function tests, breathing tests, to be able to screen patients early in the disease process and intervene early.
And what does the treatment entail?
The treatment predominantly is inhalers, much like asthma patients, but the medications are a little bit different. Okay. But predominant treatment is inhalers and prevention.
And of course, the best treatment is to stop smoking for anyone that is smoking. Unfortunately, like Dr. Pollard said, 1 in 6 of us never smoked. I was one that never smoked, and I shouldn't have it, but
You get it anyway. Tell us a few of the events going on next month.
On Friday, November 2nd, we are having grand rounds for the physicians and healthcare professionals from 8 to 9. We're having Dr. James Kiley, who is the lung director from the National Heart, Lung, Blood Institute. He's going to come and speak about current concepts and future research directions for chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD. In fact, they just funded a $43 million study to help with figuring out why people get COPD and maybe start working at some of the causes and the root treatment. And then from 10:30 to 2:30 at Queen's Conference Center, there is an event that we put together. It's a COPD Awareness Day. Unfortunately, due to the overwhelming response, we can't accept any more people to register. But if people want to come at 1 o'clock, they can come and look at the exhibits. We will have over 20 exhibitors, including the Med School and the Department of Health Tobacco Prevention and Education Program, and a lot of vendors and all kinds of people that have good information to share.
Great. Well, thank you so much, both of you, for being with us and helping to bring awareness to this disease.
Well, thank you so
much.
Thank
you.
And happy Halloween to you.
Happy Halloween.
You too. It is 6:57. We'll be back with all our top stories here on Hawaii's Morning News. Please stay with us.